Welcome to online tutorial class. Myself Anamika, assistant professor, Department of Psychology, JL College, Hajipur. Today we'll discuss behavioral therapy. Behavior therapy is an umbrella term for types of therapy that treat mental health disorders. This form of therapy seeks to identify and help change potentially self-destructive or unhealthy behaviors. It functions on the idea that all behavior are learned and that unhealthy behavior can be changed. The focus of treatment is often on a current problem and how to change them. The foundation of behavioral therapy. In order to understand how behavioral therapy works, let's start by exploring the two basic principles that contribute to behavioral therapy, classical and operant conditioning. Classical conditioning involves forming association between stimuli. Previously, neutral stimulus are paired with a stimulus that naturally and automatically evokes a response. After repeated pairing, an association is formed and the previously neutral stimulus will come to evoke the response on its own. Now, operant conditioning. Operant conditioning focuses on how reinforcement and punishment can be utilized to either increase or decrease the frequency of behavior. Behavior followed by desired consequences are more likely to occur again in the future, while those followed by negative consequences become less likely to occur. Behavior therapy based on classical conditioning. Classical conditioning is one way to alter behavior, and a number of techniques exist that can produce such change. Originally known as behavior modification, this type of therapy is often referred to today as applied behavior analysis. There are several different techniques and strategies used in this approach to therapy. Now we discuss some of the most famous classical conditioning based behavior therapy. Flooding. The process involves exposing people to fear-invoking object or situation intensely and rapidly. It is often used to treat phobia. During the process, the individual is prevented from escaping or avoiding the situation. For example, flooding might be used to help a person who is suffering from an intense fear of dogs. At first, the client might be exposed to a small, friendly dog for an extended period of time during which they cannot leave. After repeated exposure to the dog, during which nothing bad happened, the fear response begins to fade. Systematic desensitization. In this technique, a client make a list of fears and then learn to relax while concentrating on these fears. The use of this process began with psychologist John B. Watson and his famous Little Albert experiment, in which he conditioned a young child to fear a white rat. Later, Mercy Cover Jones replicated Watson's result and utilized counter-conditioning technique to desensitize and eliminated the fear response. Systematic desensitization is often used to treat phobia and other anxiety disorder. The process follows three basic steps. First, the therapist teaches the client relaxation techniques. And second, next, the individual creates a rank list of fear-invoking situations. And third one is starting with the least fear-inducing item and working their way up to the most fear-inducing item. The client confronts these fears under the guidance of the therapist while maintaining a relaxed situation. For example, an individual with a fear of dark might start by looking at the image of a dark room before moving on to thinking about being in the dark room and then actually confronting the fear by sitting in a dark room. By pairing the old fear-producing stimulus with the newly learned relaxation behavior, the phobia response can be reduced or even eliminated. Aversion therapy is also a behavior therapy. In this process, they involve pairing an undesirable behavior with an aversive stimulus in the hope that the unwanted behavior will eventually be reduced. For example, someone suffering from alcoholism might take desulfiram, a drug which causes severe symptoms such as headache, nausea, and anxiety and vomiting when combined with alcohol. most people who take disulfiram, it will vomit after a drink of alcohol. This in turn is thought to create a deterrent to drinking. Now we discuss behavior therapy based on operant conditioning. Many behavior technique rely on the principle of operant conditioning, which means that they use reinforcement, punishment, shaping, modeling and related technique to alter behavior. These methods have the benefit of being highly focused, which means that they can produce fast and effective result. Token economies. This type of behavioral strategy relies on reinforcement to modify behavior. Clients are allowed to earn tokens that can be exchanged for special privilege or desired item. Parents and teachers often use token economics to reinforce good behavior. Kids earn token for engaging in preferred behavior and may lose token for displaying undesirable behavior. This token can then be traded for rewards such as a candy, toys or extra time playing with their favorite toys. Another is contingency management. This approach uses a formal written contract between a client and a therapist that outline behavior change goals, reinforcement, rewards and penalties. Contingency contract can be very effective in producing behavior changes since the rules are spelled out clearly, preventing both parties from backing down on their promises. Modeling. Modeling is another behavior therapy. This technique involves learning through observation and modeling the behavior of others. The process is based on Albert Bandura's social learning theories, which emphasizes the social component of the learning process. Rather than relying simply on reinforcement and punishment, modeling allows individuals to learn new skills or accepting behavior by watching someone else perform those desired skills. In some cases, the therapist might model the desired behavior. In other instances, watching peers engage in sought after behavior can also be helpful. Extinction is another behavior therapy. Another way to produce behavior change is to stop reinforcement of behavior in order to eliminate the response. Timeout are a perfect example of the extinction process. During a timeout, a person is removed from a situation that provides reinforcement. For example, a child who starts yelling or striking other children would be removed from the group and required to sit quietly in a place where there are no opportunities for attention and reinforcement. By taking away the attention that the child found rewarding, the unwanted behavior is eventually extinguished. Now the conclusion of the study. When it's come to treating a specific behavioral issue, behavioral therapy can sometimes be more effective than other approaches. Phobia and obsessive compulsive disorder responds well to behavioral treatment. However, behavioral approaches are not always the best solution. For example, behavioral therapy is generally not the best approach when treating certain psychiatric disorders such as depression and schizophrenia. Behavior therapy might be effective at helping client manage or cope with certain aspects of these psychiatric conditions, but it should be used in conjunction with other medical and therapeutic treatments. Thank you.